don't mind paying for something that is that brilliant.
Pasta is not evil, it's how much pasta you eat.
It goes straight to the pleasure center for me and bypasses the thinking center.
They're little fried bits of heaven, in my opinion.
Oh God, I'm going to be sick.
How about those desserts?
Hello, I'm Doug Frost, and welcome to Check Please, the show where regular folks from all over Kansas City dine and dish on their favorite restaurants. This is how the show works. Every week, we have three guests. Each recommends his or her favorite spot, while the other two go to check them out to see what they think. This week, political operative Sophie McCarthy campaigns that her pick has all the makings of a winning candidate. She urges you to cast your vote for the best tapas on the West Side. But for independent video producer Dave Simmons, he says you can't produce a better meal or atmosphere than his pick. Dave invites you to tune into his favorite restaurant in Westport. But up first, entrepreneur Donna Jolly believes you've got to take risks in order to be successful. That's why she chose this vegan restaurant on the east side of Kansas City. Donna says in order to grow, you've got to go to Cafe Seed.
Well, we had a bookstore in Brooklyn, and it was a cafe as well. When we decided to relocate, we came here, and we always wanted to open up a vegan cafe, but it took 3 years, and we finally got here.
You know, we always had a lot of challenges trying to go somewhere to meet our specific dietary needs and get the quality of food that we felt was best. So, you know, that was also a strong motivator.
There's two things that as a vegan it's difficult to get your hands on, and that's baked goods and sweets and pastries, and then it's breakfast. And those are two things that we highlight here. You can come out for brunch and have a spectacular breakfast. Anything a vegan could ask for breakfast, we try to provide for you here. And then the sweets are just gonna be off the chain.
And I absolutely guarantee for the non-vegetarian or vegan individuals, they will not miss what's not in our menu. Nothing will be missed. And we want the environment to be stimulating, you know, visually as well as, you know, intellectually. So we have a lot of what some people might term alternative information or alternative media. We have a lot of information about veganism and health.
What I strove for is someplace that I would want to come. As a vegan, someplace that I would want to come and eat and hang out. That's what I was hoping for, and I think, hopefully, that's what we achieved.
Now, Donna, you're not a vegetarian.
No.
So why did you choose a vegan restaurant?
Well, it's my sister's fault. One day we were out, and she said, hey, let's go to this new restaurant. And I was like, okay. And she's like, it's vegetarian, it's vegan. And I'm looking at her like, okay, you're why? But we went, and I enjoyed myself immensely that first time, and the food was good. I kid you not. They have this hamburger. It's not a hamburger. It's a vegan burger, but it tastes like the old style burgers that you used to get when you were a kid, you know, when the beef actually tasted like beef.
Yeah, there's a
and
lot.
The butter was on the bun, and oh, yeah. You know, and it's just so good. And so I'm eating this, and I'm like, no, seriously, is this like vegetables? No, for real, what's in this? And it was so good. And so I was like, yes, this is my new favorite restaurant.
But the menu, you could look at the menu, it's like hamburgers, tacos.
Yes.
Like, you wouldn't have to be vegan.
Yes, it's
BLT.
BLT? Yes.
The BLT?
Yes.
Yeah, you had BLT, right?
Yep. Soy bacon.
Did you like that?
I did. I went in with several kind of preconceived notions about a vegan restaurant. I really tried to have an open mind, but there's just certain things. And some of those preconceived notions were met. There was, you know, the tribal drum loop on the boombox plant. And you know, some of that.
I like reggae. Come on.
That's what I pictured.
Some of that stuff, but in all honesty, when I left, those notions were thrown out the door because the food was great, mm-hmm. and it was filling. And I, you know, my fears were I'm going to go in, I'm going to get like a soy taco or some weird, you know, and literally I'm going to walk out of here and I'm going to have to go
eat something else.
But the food came out and the food was awesome and the salad was enormous. And
which salad did you have?
The pear walnut salad.
That's so delicious.
Yeah, the pear pecan.
It came out.
It's a good size salad.
Enormous.
Really,
and the fresh fruit smoothies were
nice.
Which smoothie did you
have? I had the One Love. Speaking of reggae.
I had the pina colada, which was also very good.
Yeah, and what was your experience like, Sophie?
I had the pancakes, which were amazing. I have no idea what was in them, but they
not
were
necessary.
And they were like, they had a little bit of a different taste. I mean, you know, it didn't taste just like a regular pancake, but it was still really, really good. And I also had the bacon, which I was like totally turned off by, though. I thought it came to my plate and I looked like it had been ironed. I mean, it was like just this completely flat strip, but it's not turkey. It's
you
like,
get
I don't
it,
even
you
know
gotta
what
get it,
it
on
is.
A sandwich and then just don't ever open that
I
up.
Know, it's crunchy.
I have the BLT.
You leave it still crunchy.
Still crunchy. Okay.
I left it
and
on
it
the BLT.
It like bacon. It's got no, it does not taste like bacon. There is no delicious salty fat in it. It's not greasy. It does not taste like bacon.
You're smuggling bacon in next time, aren't you?
I am a bacon connoisseur. I know my bacon. I love my bacon.
I think we should let that one lie. Serious bacon attitude here. So what makes it a quirky restaurant?
Quirky restaurant. Well, first of all, the neighborhood is kind of, it's off of Gillum.
Right.
So it's not really where you would think a restaurant would be. And then you walk in and it's kind of stark, clean, just the whole Swedish look to it.
There is definitely
it's more of a laid back,
right.
very slow, almost like an island kind of feel to it where
there's
you
couches
rush.
And a chess board set up in right. the front window where it's like, who's got time for chess at lunch? You know, it's like, so definitely kind of that different, kind of a different vibe. And as we were there, you could tell it was a very neighborhood place. People that came in knew each other and knew the owner and knew that. And I love that. I think that's endearing.
Yeah.
I think
yeah,
that's really something that draws me back where it's like, you know, you almost want to be a part of it, but that first time in is a little, you know.
I totally agree with Dave on that. You know, it's just something like, it's not like every other restaurant, and I loved that about it. And it was charming that, like, the guy that took my order then, like, ran back to the kitchen to make my pancake.
Yep.
But it did take a while. I mean, we had the same kind of deal. Like, it took a while for us to get served and for us to get waited on. And we were there with my daughter. I have a 2-year-old little girl. Who was like about to eat her arm, and so we were like, please get the pancakes here, we don't have time. But luckily the chess set kept her entertained for quite a while, so it worked out for us.
Bang for the buck, what do you think? I mean, that pecan pear salad was
awesome.
Yeah,
and the smoothies were fantastic, and I would go back. I mean, probably not gonna become vegan, but you know, there is, when you leave, you're not that, you know, you've not just eaten a huge hamburger, you know, you feel good, you feel kind of energized, you've just had this fruit smoothie that's, you know, packed full of stuff that I'm sure I don't even know what's in there, but it was delicious, the salad was awesome, the BLT, I'd eat again.
Yeah, and Sophie, what do you think, bang for the buck?
I would gladly go back with a vegetarian or vegan friend. Like, I like it, and I think it's charming, and I hope it does really, really well.
Wonderful. Well, Donna, this was, Cafe Seed was your pick, so give us a little summary, if you would.
A little summary, it's the out-of-the-way, quaint, yet eclectic Saturday afternoon, you don't have that much to do, hang out where you can eat something healthy, not feel guilty after eating it, and meet different people from Kansas City. I mean, it's got all types of people
there. That sounds great. You can grow your palate at Cafe Seed, 2932 Cherry Street. 816-561-7333 is their phone number. They're open for lunch Tuesday through Saturday, open for dinner Thursday through Saturday, and they're open for brunch Saturday and Sunday. Reservations are not needed, and the average tab per person without drinks is $15. If independent video producer Dave Simmons could write a show about his pick, it would be a story of home, comfort food, a neighborhood feel with eclectic music, and a place that's even kid-friendly. For Dave, this award-winning restaurant is PotPie in Westport.
We named it PotPie basically because we had nothing better. PotPies themselves were, you know, secondary in the restaurant. It was, you know, we didn't even have them the first couple months we were open. The uproar that created was amazing. And now, I mean, in hindsight, you know, it was definitely the name the restaurant should have been named. The restaurant's kind of born out of, well, the kind of person I am, and I like down-home cooking food, so, but that idea of that type of food really isn't a huge stretch from, like, French country food. We call dressed-up comfort food. You know, you get a good meal, and it's at a fair price, and it's not a big deal, you know, but you're just coming to get something to eat. We have a really wide variety of clientele. You know, it feels like home. You know, everybody feels welcome. So, you know, people can come with kids, or people aren't restaurant people and don't spend a lot of time in restaurants and they're not super comfortable with restaurants. They can come here, not feel uncomfortable, not feel like they
can't find something on the wine list that, you know, is good for them or just that they can recognize or that they can afford. The juju of the pot pie isn't one specific thing, you know. It's how it feels in here. It's the, you know, the food is good. The people who work here are nice, and it translates, you know.
Dave, this sounds like this place could be your home away from home. Does your wife know about this?
She does. Yeah, she does. Good. And actually, that's a big part of why we go there. It's okay. Kid-friendly. We work in Midtown, and we live quite a ways north. And it's one of those places where we can go in the city with our kids, get a great meal, great service, occasionally live music. And there's not a stigma that's kind of attached to, you know, a lot of times you'll walk into a restaurant with a 4-year-old and a 2-year-old, and you almost get that look like, oh.
You're not welcome here.
You almost hear the little vacuum going before you eat, you know, because, I mean.
We've got a lovely table in the kitchen.
Exactly. And there's
actually, it's next door. It's somebody else's restaurant.
Yeah.
No,
and
it's
so
true.
There's a little bit of a stigma related when you walk into a nice restaurant with kids. And Pot Pie is a nice restaurant. It's very nice. It's very comfortable. The food's. I don't want people to think that it's, you know, you go in there and it's like an arrangement of pot pies. I mean, the menu is incredible. I mean, it changes often. It's eclectic. I've literally never had anything there that wasn't phenomenal.
Well, let's talk about it. What have you had there?
On the most recent visit, I had the pork loin, chili rubbed pork loin with polenta and pickled peppers.
Say that very fast.
My wife had the scallops. We were with a fairly large group, so my wife, my two kids, and another couple, on a night without reservations, were able to get in. Everybody's meal was incredible. Service was impeccable. I've had everything on the menu. Every time the pot pie changes, I try the pot pie because it's kind of one of those. You're in a place called Pot Pie. You try the pot pie.
And they're
phenomenal. I mean, yeah. And it is comfort food personified. It's just this huge baked, warm. Yeah. You know it's homemade. You know it's handmade. I mean, literally, yeah, I think the crust, he finger pinches the crust around.
And it was phyllo crust, and I was really surprised by that. The waitress told me that it was going to be more like chicken and dumpling flavor, and I was like, oh, okay, that's fine. And this, like you said, this huge dish comes out. I couldn't even finish it. And I'm sitting there, I you know, spoon into it. And it's like, oh, this is phyllo. Oh, this is good. Yeah, but it was, you could totally tell it was like made to order. It's like I ordered it.
It's not the Stouffer's pot pie out of the
definitely
freezer section.
Not that. It's a step up. High cut crust nastiness. It was good.
Donna, just your thoughts about it. I mean, did the place make sense when you walked in?
No.
Okay.
But in a good way, in a very good way. Okay. It was, you walk in and you're kind of like, okay, what are they doing here? And I thought the lady was kidding when she said, here's our menu for the day, and there's like this big chalkboard. Right. I was like, no, really, where's like the menu? So I didn't know, was I supposed to get up and go to the chalkboard? Was I supposed to just kind of, so I didn't get up, but yes, I did. I tried the pot pie. So, and I also let her choose my wine, and it was the Shoe Fly Buzz Cut, which I had never heard of. Yes, it was crisp, and it went well with chicken pot pie.
Okay, well, that's not the sort of thing you usually read on the back of a wine label, but you know.
I know, Shoe Fly Buzz Cut.
It doesn't really sell
perfect
the wine
with chicken pot
them.
Pie. Yeah. Indeed. Yes. So what'd you have for dessert?
Oh my gosh, I had this cobbler that was blackberries, blueberries, and I don't know, all these dark berries. And they were nice and tart, but then the crust that they put on top was it was sweet and buttery and flaky, and oh my God, it was good.
Yeah, it sounds really good.
Vanilla ice cream on top of that.
And Sophie, what do you think?
Yeah, well,
how was your
experience? I love pot pie. I for a lot of the same reasons that Dave mentions. I mean, it's just this charming little neighborhood joint. Never would have occurred to me to bring my daughter. It has a little more upscale feel than some place that you would think called Pot Pie. I also had the pork tenderloin, which was, I mean, it was prepared well, and I really liked it, but it was just, like, I wasn't quite in the mood for, like, a heavy dish. But I have had the scallops with the blueberry sauce there before, which I love. Like, it's probably one of my favorite meals in the city. I mean, it is so, so good. And for dessert, we had this a chocolate croissant bread pudding, which was phenomenal. It is so good, and they pour, like, I don't know, some kind of hot cream thing over it. It was really, really good. And a great deal. I mean, I think for two people, we had, you know, an appetizer, entree, dessert, and wine for $70. I mean, it was a great deal.
The prices were like, that's it.
For that charming a place, yeah. I mean, it really has an upscale feel.
Yes,
I mean,
it does.
I was really expecting the bill to at least be over $100. I was really surprised.
Very reasonable.
Yeah.
Very reasonable.
Well, Dave, PotPie was your pick, so give us a short summary of the restaurant, if you would.
Comfort food, comfortable atmosphere, locally owned and operated, fresh food, great bar, great wine selection, live music occasionally. I mean, for me, it's all of the things I look for when I go out to eat. And the fact that it's kid friendly and that I can take my kids there and hopefully you can take your kids there and have the same experience, to me, it's unbeatable. It's a rare find in this city.
That sounds great. Well, find out if your new home away from home is at PotPie, which is at 904 Westport Road. 816-561-2702 is the phone number. They're open for lunch and dinner Tuesday through Saturday. Reservations are accepted, and the average tab per person without drinks is $30. Why do people sniff corks? Because of this thing called TCA, trichloroanisole, whatever, don't even worry about it, but it smells like a Boy Scout newspaper drive. I mean, the cork does, and it ends up making the wine smell that way too. Now look, it's nobody's fault, just happens, not very often, maybe 1%, maybe 2% of the time, but the thing is, that's why some winemakers have gone to synthetic corks, which are made of like heart valve material, and certainly won't provide any sort of weird smells, but they're hard to get out of the bottle. So some people now have gone to screw caps, which, you know, that's pretty easy, and the wine tastes just as good. Political operative Sophie McCarthy enjoys the high stakes of politics, but when it comes to her food, she always votes her conscience. That's why she thinks you should choose the very charming and eclectic Lill's on 17th on the West Side.
The place was named after my dog, Lill. She was 15 and a half years old and lost her right before we opened. So it's in memory of her. And the dogs on the patio are in memory of her. I want people to come in here, feel like they can sit down, talk to their friends, just totally relax, and have a nice, slow dinner. We love the idea of tapas, food that you can share with other people, casual dining, walk up to a bar, grab a tapa. We limit our entrees because it's small. We want everything to be fresh. You know, we always have a choice of salmon, mussels, shrimp, and we always have a filet. And it's usually seasonal. You know, a couple of weeks ago, we had figs with goat cheese and reduced balsamic. Oh my gosh, it was wonderful. The bacon wrapped dates. They cannot stay away from the bacon wrapped dates. You know, we've said, if you don't like them, you don't have to pay for them, but I'm telling you, they keep coming back. But it is a really nice, relaxing place to hang out for an entire evening and sip some of my sangria.
Well, Sophie, the tapas always makes the ballot with you. What made Lill's your pick?
Well, Lill's was recommended to me by a friend, and I tried it for the first time and was totally delighted just to be surprised to even find it. I mean, it's kind of a residential neighborhood. I mean, it's near the crossroads, so there's other stuff going on there. But, you know, it's a house. It's a house that they converted into a restaurant. It kind of sits up on this hill. You got to climb kind of a big set of stairs. And they have this really kind of funky little menu with, you know, a whole page of tapas, just kind of a little bit of everything, kind of new American, and then some full plates. And I love the small plates thing. So I just think it's kind of like a good neighborhood find with an eclectic menu and
tell us
great
the
food.
Menu.
We had some bacon-wrapped dates, which are not something I would normally choose, but the owner
sounds
was like,
really
you've
good.
Got to try them. They're phenomenal. They were amazing. I loved them. And it was real bacon. It wasn't that iron stuff that you recommended.
This is bacon.
That is
bacon.
How the bacon
first
is
things
done.
First, I got bacon. So now the restaurant's good.
I got some real
good.
Bacon,
you
and it was
bacon,
really
Sophie.
Good bacon.
Got your bacon. It's okay.
And we had crab cakes that were really, I mean, just lots of fresh, you know, big chunks of crab in these crab cakes. It was good with a nice little sauce.
And they're
on
good
them.
Sized as well.
Yeah, no, they were. I mean, my husband and I had 4 tapas and were full after the end. Yeah, we had some empanadas that had like a cheese and some potatoes that had like kind of a cheesy.
Garlicky kind of.
Yeah, it was like
I
don't know, like blue cheese and garlic. I don't even know what it was, but it was.
They were amazing.
And dessert?
For dessert, I actually didn't love my dessert there. I've only had dessert there once, but we had it was a molten chocolate cake, which is fine. It was just kind of, I don't know, You loved it?
No, I had, that was there. She asked if I wanted that.
Yeah.
And we were, and I said, well, what else do you have? And she said, peach spread pudding. Ooh. And I was, oh, and they had limoncello glaze on it. Oh my gosh.
Oh
was
yeah, so, no, they totally didn't have that so, when I was there.
I was so mad because my sister got a bigger piece than I did. And I was like, I want some of yours.
Yeah. I mean, I feel like it's the kind of place, like I was there late again. And so they were out of everything else. So that was all I had. I mean, they run it, you know, yeah. There's
actually,
a lot of people
for
in
a
there.
Fan of that's a good sign.
Yeah, right.
They
exactly.
bought appropriately. They had a busy night.
Yep.
And they're out of it.
Yeah,
as opposed
exactly.
to. Oh, we'll go hammer this out of the freezer
right.
and, you know.
Here's so some Twinkies
Tuesday's
with some
leftovers.
Ice cream.
No
exactly.
problem.
Exactly. So, Donna, what did you have at Lill's?
I went for lunch on a Saturday and had their signature sandwich, which was very delicious. It was ham, almost to your bacon, Sophie.
Very close
but
to bacon.
Not iron like you like not, your meat.
It's kind of
nothing
flat,
wrong
though.
With flat bacon.
That's right.
But no, but I had their signature sandwich, which was ham, apple, and boursin on artisan bread. So I pick up my sandwich and I'm like, why do I feel meat? And I turn it over and there's this huge air pocket, like the air pocket was like that big. But it was a really good sandwich. It was very good. And I liked the texture of the bread with the ham and the apples and the boursin. So
and
that was
yeah, great. That bread all comes from that little bread maker. Like,
Favre.
Yeah, Favre, oh. just next door. Yeah, it's like just around the corner.
Oh.
Yeah.
Who would you take to a restaurant like that? I mean, you know, who do you think is ideal?
My sister and I actually said that we might make that a once a month type place and hang out and just kind of see who comes in. It was neat.
It's yeah. very comfortable for that. It seems like it's kind yeah. of made for that just kind of, you know,
relax.
Like you said, the food portions are kind of made for communal
yeah.
Yeah,
kind
and,
of an aspect.
And what did you have? What'd you have?
We a lot of the same things that Sophie did. We had the empanadas and the sauteed shrimp and the bacon wrapped dates, which are everybody at our table, and we were there with six people, literally everybody was like, dates, really?
I don't, right, I know. I would have never, like, I hate dates. I would
so,
never
you know,
eat a date.
We've discussed what a date actually is. It's not really, it's not native to Missouri, so you don't get a lot of fresh
True
dates.
Enough.
But
True.
I got that feeling where it would be a great place to go to sit down with friends if you had 3 hours and wanted
right.
to kill a couple of bottles of wine and have some great food.
Let's talk crass commerce for a second. I mean, what do you think of bang for the buck at Lill's?
I think bang for the buck at Lill's was very high. I thought the food was great. The atmosphere was great. I'd go back in a heartbeat.
See, Dave, yeah. I'd have to disagree just slightly.
Yeah.
I thought it was a little bit higher than the other two
for the
meal that I got. But going with the atmosphere and the theme that they were doing, I was like, oh, I can deal with this. But like I said, once a month tops for a restaurant.
Well, don't get me wrong, because I agree. Maybe more of kind of a special occasion, mm-hmm. but make more special occasions.
Yeah.
Sophie, if you wouldn't mind giving us a quick summary of Lill's, what did you think?
Lill's is an unexpected little neighborhood place, a great place for a special occasion, maybe if you want to try some different foods that you haven't tried and get a taste of a sampling of a lot of different kinds of foods.
There you go. Well, you can decide for yourself at Lill's on 17th. It's at 815 West 17th Street. Phone number is 816-421-4441. It's open for lunch and dinner Wednesday through Saturday. Reservations are definitely helpful, and the average tab per person without drinks is $25. So on this week's show, we featured Cafe Seed on the East Side, the place Donna said is her new favorite restaurant, and where Sophie said, well, she'd rather have real bacon. But Dave said that while he may not turn vegan, he will return to Cafe Seed. And we featured Pot Pie in Westport, where Dave said the food is comfort personified. And Donna said she's gooey over the desserts. Sophie said the next time she goes to Pot Pie, she's bringing the kids. Finally, we featured Lill's on 17th on the west side, where Sophie said it's a great place for tapas and fun with friends. Donna said it's only a once in an occasion kind of place, but Dave said, make more occasions. I want to thank my guests, Donna Jolly, Sophie McCarthy, and Dave Simmons. Join us next week for three new guests recommending three of their favorite restaurants right here on Check Please. I'm Doug Frost, and I'll see you then. Cheers.
Cheers.
I'm Underwriting for the production of Check Please has been provided by Bank of America, Bank of Opportunity.